But the real laugh is, of course, the resolution of anxiety. The anxiety is serious. And anxiety is a state of palpitation, of the trembles. Anxiety comes upon us when we cannot decide which way to go, or which way things are going to go. And so we tremble between alternatives. Now, because, of course, we tremble between alternatives, because we are under the illusion that it matters very much which of these two things happens. Now, once one has seen the nature of the game, you realize that it matters superficially which of these two things happens, but it doesn't fundamentally matter, because all negative things pair with positives. There is no positive without negative, and there is no negative without positive. I heard a very amusing story, which kind of goes with these rugs. The question is a zebra a yellow horse with black stripes, or a black horse with yellow stripes? The answer is, it is an invisible horse, which has been striped yellow and black so that people won't bump into it. Now, in a similar way, reality is an invisible state of affairs, beyond all description and thought, but it has been striped black and white, so as to be seen. And this is life and death, up and down, sound and silence, the whole vibratory character of being. And the game, the fundamental game that the universe is playing, is to forget that this is so. You see, what you might say, feel in theological language, the invisibility of God is his self-forgetfulness. And the visibility of the world is the game being played. Now, the nature of the game, I think I've told some of you this before, but I see some I haven't. The nature of the game is, let us pretend that the positive and the negative are not really identical. You see, they're explicitly different, but implicitly the same, because they always go around together. And that reveals a hidden, implicit conspiracy between black and white. And the truth is, you can't have one without the other. But if we can pretend that they don't go together, that they are actually enemies, then we can have all sorts of games, the first game of which is, oh dear, black might win. The next game is, but white must win. And from that position, you can develop all the games you want. And it's interesting, isn't it, how so many of our table games, like chess and dominoes and checkers and so on, use the black and white pieces. And you can find in the conventions of chess, one could discuss all this, the problem, in terms of chess. When I bring up the joker, of course, we are in a way discussing it in terms of the game of cards, because the joker is the card beyond roll, the card that's wild, that can be any card in the pack. In other words, it's delivered from being a particular someone and can be in anyone. And it pops up here, and it pops up there, and it pops up here. And you never know, where is the joker? Who is the joker? You see? The thing that we have to understand, really, is that all the roles are the joker playing them. And the joker is looking at you out of all pairs of eyes. There he is. Only he's pretending very often that he's not the Joker at all. Oh no, this is just me. I'm not the Joker. Where is the Joker?